Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. In this video, I will bring to you the best multiple choice questions from the third week of March, that is from 15th of March to 21st of March in English. This video will be in English language for all the people who prefer to watch it in English. And if you want to follow me on Facebook, now more than 41,000 people are following me on Facebook for receiving various updates. Not only updates, I also share a lot of interesting articles and political news also, and it will help you definitely to stay updated. So that's the link. It will be in the description below. And a quick update about our pen drive courses. We are providing one video daily apart from the 200 plus videos that are there in the pen drive for all these exams. If you want to avail any of our pen drive, one of the best ways to prepare for your exams in the shortest way possible, especially for those who do not have a coaching center nearby or who prefer to have the best quality at their disposal in the comfort of their homes. So that's the number that you have to dial, 958-004-8004. So let's begin without further ado. Our Commerce and Industry Minister, she launched the Trade Infrastructure for Export Scheme, that is the TIES scheme. Please note, we'll make a separate video elaborating what is TIES scheme. That will be up tomorrow morning. What is the name of our Commerce Secretary who will chair the empowered committee that is being set up under the TIES scheme? Now please pay attention to the question. We are not asking who is our Union Commerce Minister. We are asking who is our Commerce Secretary. So her name is Rita Teotia. And our Commerce Minister is her, Nirmala Sitaraman. And this is a very, very important scheme. It will have a total budget allocation of 600 crore rupees for 3 years. And 200 crore will be spent for 3 years. So total 600 crore rupees will be spent. And this scheme will apply from 1st April 2017. The same date from which GAR will apply. Journal Anti Avoidance Rule, GAR, will also apply from 1st April 2017. A 3-day international conference on Vision Zero and Occupational Safety and Health was recently held at which place? And this was organized by the DGFA SLI, that is the Directorate General Factory Advice and Labor Institute, and German Social Accident Insurance, basically to help combat various accidents and which are occupational hazards. And to promote occupational safety, this took place in the capital, New Delhi. New Delhi governor, it was asked in one of the exam recently, and a lot of people wrote Najib Jung. Najib Jung is no more the Delhi governor. It is Anil Baijal. So keep yourself updated. Anil Baijal is the minister. One more thing I want to tell you. I have bought a new writing plate because a lot of students used to complain that my handwriting is not decipherable. It is not readable. So you will see improved handwriting in this video. Anyways, who was sworn in as the new chief minister of Manipur? So let's get the facts straight. There were 5 state union territories combined in which elections took place recently, and all of the 5 have new chief minister. New chief minister of Manipur is Biren Singh of the Bharatiya Janata Party. Of Goa is Manohar Parikar, who was our ex-defense minister. And now the defense ministry has gone to Arun Jaitley. And Punjab, we have a new chief minister, Captain Amrinder Singh of Congress. Uttarakhand, we have Trivendar. Okay, so I will give you a learning mnemonic. Okay, Maharashtra, we have Devendar. Okay, and Devendar Singh Fadnavis. Devendar Fadnavis. And in Uttarakhand, we have Trivendar. So, and UP, it is Yogi Adityanath, the very animated character. And let me tell you the governor also. Because 5 states governor is the one who gives the chief minister the oath. So Manipur, we have Najma Haptullah. If you remember, Najma Haptullah was our minorities affair minister previously. And in Goa, we have Mridula Sinha. Mridula Sinha. Punjab, everybody knows, VP Singh Badnore. VP Singh Badnore. And Uttarakhand is KK Paul. Krishna Kant Paul. UP is Ram Nayak. If you remember, Ram Nayak used to stand from the South Mumbai constituency. He was defeated by Govinda in the elections. So these are all the people who are the governors right now. And one question I guarantee you from these 5, either chief minister or governor. Which neighboring country of India successfully test fired a land-based anti-ship missile? Land-based anti-ship missile. It was recently fired by Pakistan, and this will give Pakistan some room in the Arabian Sea. Anyways, so Navy, there was no specific details given regarding this by the Navy of Pakistan. And Chief of Naval Staff of Pakistan is Muhammad Zakaullah. Muhammad Zakaullah is the Chief of Navy in Pakistan. Next, ONGC, Oil and Natural Gas Corporation, which is a Maharatan company, very, very important PSU. It has announced to develop India's deepest gas discovery, Ultra Deep Sea UD1 by 2022-23 with an investment of how much? This is a very, very ambitious project. Look at the outlay for the project. It is huge. So the money that they have kept for it is 21,500 crore rupees. And they plan to drill 9 wells on the discovery that lies in water depths of 2400 to 3200 meters. So 9 wells will be drilled. And ONGC headquarters is in Dehradun. Okay, and who is the CEO of ONGC right now? Dinesh Saraf. Dinesh Saraf is the CEO of ONGC, and ONGC headquarters is in Dehradun. Which public sector bank has tied up with Future Generali India Insurance Company Limited for bunk assurance? Bunk assurance is when a bank ties up with an insurance company, because insurance companies generally they do not have a very big consumer base, and banks have a consumer base, but banks do not have a dedicated insurance product line. So what happens is banks tie up with the insurance company, they charge their commission, but banks are able to sell the insurance products to their own consumer base. That is how both of these benefit. This is called bunk assurance. And Future Generali, the bank which has tied up, is UCO Bank. Please note, UCO Bank is headquartered at Kolkata. Not many banks have their headquarters in Kolkata. In fact, let me tell you a fact. UCO Bank was established just before independence of India, around 1942. And after independence, there is only one bank which has its headquarters in any of the eastern states of India. That bank is Bandhan Bank. Apart from UCO Bank and Bandhan Bank, which was opened very recently, in fact, just 2 years back, no other bank has its headquarters in any of the eastern states of India. So that is why you should absolutely know the headquarters of UCO Bank. And UCO Bank, they can ask the CEO also. It is Ravi Krishna Takkar. Ravi Takkar is the CEO of UCO Bank. So that's all you need to know. For which disease did India sign World Health Organization's call for action and pledge to scale up measures to end the disease by 2030? Very, very important disease which has affected almost 70% of population of India. I'm not saying that 70% population of India is active diseased by this disease, but it is a carrier also. So World Health Organization, it's headquartered at Geneva, the beautiful town in Switzerland, and this disease is tuberculosis. India reports 28 lakh cases of tuberculosis annually. Do you know that? And 5 lakh people in India, they die annually from tuberculosis. So and WHO's head is very, very important. It has been asked time and again. Margaret Chan. Okay, Margaret Chan. There is another Chan who is in news. Priscilla Chan, wife of Mark Zuckerberg. Her name is Priscilla Chan. When was World Consumer Rights Day with the theme Building a Digital World Consumers Can Trust? It was observed. So this is very important. We should build a digital ecosystem in which the consumers are no more afraid to do the transactions digitally or cashless. And for that, World Consumer Day recently had the theme this. And it was observed just like every year on March 15th. And this day actually was started by a president of United States, John F. Kennedy. If you remember, John F. Kennedy was assassinated. And till date, we don't know who killed him. This is one of the biggest mysteries of the world. Though some say that Oswald killed him, but we don't know for sure. And this day started in the year 1983. But there is a catch here. Okay, what is the catch? In India, we celebrate National Consumer Rights Day on 24 December. So always look at the question carefully. Are they asking World Consumer Rights Day? Or are they asking National Consumer Right Day? World Consumer Right Day, March 15. National Consumer Right Day, 24 December. Okay, so keep those things in mind. And 24 December is very important date. And you know why? Because 23rd December, one day before, we have birthday of we have Kisan Divas, the birthday of Chaudhary Charan Singh, who was the ex-Prime Minister of India. And on one day later, on 25th December, yes, we do have Christmas, but we have Good Governance Day, which is the birthday of Atal Bihari Vajpayee Ji. So 24th December falls in between the birthdays of two ex-prime ministers. And 26th December, we have the Boxing Day. which bank has acquired 100% stake in the brokerage company Infrastructure Leasing and Financial Services, ILNFS, Security Service Subsidiary, which is called ISSL. So, which bank has acquired 100% stake, which means bank has completely acquired this company. This bank is the IndusInd Bank. And IndusInd Bank has its headquarter in Mumbai. See, 90%, you can say 80% banks, they are headquartered in Mumbai. All the big banks mostly are headquartered in Mumbai. So, if you don't know the answer, you can take a guess. Okay. And CEO, important person, Romesh Sobti. Next. Who has been sworn in as Upalokayukt of Assam by the Governor Banwari Lal Purohit. Banwari Lal Purohit is Governor of Assam. This is important. Assam, for the first time in the history of Assam, we had a BJP government. And Chief Minister is Sarbanand Sonowal. Okay, remember that. So, who was sworn in as the Uplokayukt? It is Mr. Chitranjan Sharma. Do you know who is Uplokayukt, by the way? Uplokayukt is Anti-Corruption Ombudsman. You must have heard the word Ombudsman in the banking ecosystem. Ombudsman is a person who is appointed by the state for grievances redressal, etc. Similarly, Anti-Corruption Ombudsman is the Uplokayukt. Where did Bhel, Bharat Heavy Electricals Limited, Maharatan Company, very important, PSU. So, where did Bhel's first 800 megawatt supercritical thermal power plant become operational recently? So, it was in Raichur. And Raichur is in Karnataka. See, you should not confuse Raichur with Raipur, okay? Naya Raipur is the capital of Chhattisgarh, and there is a Raigad also in Chhattisgarh. So this is Raichur, it is in Karnataka, and this is the Yera Maras thermal power station of Raichur. So 800 megawatt is the capacity, and Bhel's headquarter is where? It is in New Delhi, and Bhel's CEO is Atul Sobti. Okay. Our agriculture minister, Radha Mohan Singh, he inaugurated Krishi Unnati Mela. Krishi means agriculture, Unnati means progress. So, agriculture progress fair in New Delhi announced to link 400 out of 585 wholesale mandis nationwide by March end with the electronic trading platform, which is called what? So, all the mandi. See, mandi is basically a place where there is buying and selling. It is like a shopping platform where there are shoppers and there are buyers. Where there are buyers and there are sellers. So, it's like a market. Okay, where agriculture produce is sold and bought. So, what is the name of that digital platform which will connect 400 out of 585 mandis? It is called ENAM. ENAM. That is the name which they have given it. And this 3-day fair was organized by the Indian Agriculture Research Institute, which is called IARI, and Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. So, that's all you need to know. Electronic trading platform is called ENAM. Our finance minister is Arun Jaitley, but this state's finance minister is Yanamala Ramkrishnudu. And he presented a 1.57 lakh crore budget for which state? So, basically, and you know that finance budgets were presented for almost all the states by their respective finance ministers. And so, Yanamala Ramkrishnudu is of Andhra Pradesh. Andhra Pradesh. And Andhra Pradesh, it has a Telugu Desam party, and Chief Minister is Chandrababu Naidu. As per a find or a study published in Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences, which is the first amphibian in which fluorescent molecules were found. Fluorescence means when an animal glows. Okay. Now, amphibian. Amphibian means the one who can survive in water and on land, both. Like frog. Frog is an amphibian. Rana tigrina, Rana hexadactyla, a lot of species of frogs. Anyways. So, which is the first amphibian in which fluorescent molecules were found? It is, in fact, frog. But species is different. But species you need not know. And this particular frog is called polka dot free frog. Okay. This frog has no dots over his body. It's called polka dot free frog. And it was collected in Argentina, the place of Messi and Maradona. Argentina's capital is Buenos Aires, and Argentina, you know, is in South America. So, fluorescent creatures are those which glow. Which city has topped the quality of living rankings released by world's largest human resources consulting company called Mercer? Which city has topped quality of living ranking? This city is Vienna. Vienna is in Austria. It is the capital of Austria. And one of the most asked cities, because a lot of things have happened here. Vienna Convention, and I mean, if you study World War II. So Vienna is the answer. And let me tell you, Vienna has topped for 8th year in a row. Not the first time. Second city was Zurich, the beautiful town of Zurich in Switzerland. And the third was Auckland. Auckland is in New Zealand, but it is not the capital of New Zealand. Capital of New Zealand is Wellington. So top city in India was Hyderabad. That you can know. The worst city to live in the world is Baghdad, which is the capital of Iraq. And there are a lot of reasons for that. Iraq, you know, it is infested by Islamic group ISIS. And a lot of other reasons are also there. So Mercer company is headquartered in New York. And New York also has headquartered of UNICEF and United Nations in general. Who has been appointed as the chief executive officer, CEO of Reliance Commercial Finance? It is Mr. Devang Modi. So just mug up the name. When was Commonwealth Day celebrated? And the theme was a peace-building Commonwealth. Commonwealth, by the way, has 52 countries as its members. 52 nations are there on Commonwealth. It was celebrated on March the 13th. That is the Commonwealth Day. Which country held its first ever Girls' Council led by the Prince Faisal bin Misal bin Saud to increase women participation in workforce? For the first time there was a Girls' Council. This country is also waking up to the women empowerment, and it increased women's participation in the workforce from 22% to 30%. And this is their vision by 2030. They plan to increase number of women in the workforce from 22 to 30%. This country is Saudi Arabia. The capital of Saudi Arabia is in Riyadh, and the currency is Riyal, and the king is King Salman. Joanna Russell-Shand, the British Olympic champion, recently announced her retirement. She used to play which sport? She's an Olympic champion. She used to play cycling. Apex body, that is the topmost body of Private Real Estate Developers Association, which is called CREDAI. It has tied up with which bank for Housing for All initiative? Now, Housing for All, you know, by 2022, 5 crore houses will be built. 3 crore in rural area, 2 crore in urban area. That is the Housing for All initiative by Narendra Modi. Now, Apex body of Private Real Estate Developers Association, CREDAI, has tied up with which bank for this? It has tied up with State Bank of India. By the way, State Bank of India, you know, it is merging with 5 associate banks. But now, just I heard in news day before yesterday, even Bharatiya Mahila Bank will merge with State Bank of India, as announced by our official Twitter handle of Ministry of Finance. So State Bank of India's chairman is Arundhati Bhattacharya, who is also one of the most powerful women in the world. Commerce and Industry Minister Nirmala Sitharaman introduced a bill in Lok Sabha to declare which of the following an institute of national importance. So which institute will be declared an institute of national importance? Very, very important question. It is the Footwear Design and Development Institute. Footwear Design and Development Institute. It was established in 1986. And do you know that India is the third biggest maker of footwear in the world? Now, first question for you today. Where is Footwear Design and Development Institute? Can you tell me at which place is Footwear Design and Development Institute located in India? That is your first question for you today. As per the Ministry of External Affairs, what is India's contribution to the United Nations? And India's contribution, in fact, rose in fiscal 2015-16 by 55%. Now, what is the India's contribution? It is 244 crore rupees. And who is our Union Minister for External Affairs? Sushma Swaraj. And who is the Secretary General or Chief of UN? It is Antonio Guterres. And if you remember, Antonio Guterres was the ex-Prime Minister of Portugal. And Antonio Guterres, you should not confuse with Antonio Costa. Okay? Antonio Guterres is different. Antonio Costa is different. Both are different. And Antonio Costa was our chief guest at the Pravasi Bharatiya Divas, not Antonio Guterres. So when you study current affairs, study in proper perspective. Anyways, which of the following upcoming solar projects in Madhya Pradesh will be getting a loan from World Bank for developing internal transmission arrangements for solar, powering solar? By the way, India is also a party, not just a party. India is one of the leaders, one of the pioneers. Two countries started International Solar Alliance, India and France. They were spearheading this alliance. So World Bank is giving us a loan for which project in Madhya Pradesh? It is the Rewa Ultra Mega Solar Project. And it is in short called RUMS, Rewa Ultra Mega Solar Project, to be built at Rewa. My second question for you today, which river was called Rewa? Which river was previously called Rewa? Important river, very, very important river. Hey, I will give you a hint. It is a western flowing river. That is, it falls in the Arabian Sea. Which of the following port trusts has signed an MOU with Puducherry government for handling exim cargo originating from Puducherry port hinterland? So that's what you need to answer. Which of the following port trusts has signed MOU with Puducherry government? See, Puducherry chief minister is V. Narayana Swamy of Congress, and it is the Chennai Port Trust which has signed MOU, and exim is export import. What is the name of American filmmaker and author of the popular article "You May Want to Marry My Husband"? And this person recently passed away. Her name is Emmy Krause Rosenthal, and she died of cancer. For which type of agricultural loans has State Bank of India given a 6,000 crore one-time settlement scheme for defaulting borrowers? For which type of agricultural loans? This has been done for the tractor loans. And bank is saying that it is willing to write off 40% of the outstanding principal amount under this scheme. Reserve Bank of India announced to open up a unified payment interface platform for digital wallet companies as part of the government's digitization campaign. So what is UPI? What does UPI stand for? So as I said, it stands for Unified Payment Interface. That is first. And that's all you need to know. Who has resigned from the chairmanship of the International Cricket Council, ICC, chairman? He resigned. His name is Shashank Manohar. And please note that BCCI CEO is Rahul Johri. Rahul Johri is the CEO of BCCI, and ICC president is Zahir Abbas, who was also called Bradman of Asia, Pakistan cricketer. And CEO of ICC is David Richardson. David Richardson. As per a recent study which was published in the journal Nature, climate change, which of the following have caused about 30 to 50% of the Arctic Sea ice losses since 1979? Since 1979, which of these things is responsible for 30% of loss of Arctic Sea ice? It is the natural swings. Natural swings. What are natural swings? These are the random changes in the wind patterns. And the rest of the change is by the man-made global warming. Which of the following is or are the only Indian companies to feature in the list of world's most ethical companies by American think tank Ethisphere Institute? So which of these companies are the found their name in the world's most ethical? Ethical companies mean which follow very sound moral practices. It is Wipro and Tata only. So the answer is 2 and 4. Wipro and Tata. And total 124 companies were listed from 5 continents. Next, with which country has Saudi Arabia signed an MOU on investment cooperation, which is valued at $65 billion? $65 billion. Saudi Arabia has signed it with powerful China. Capital of China is Beijing. Beijing is also the headquarters of Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank. And there is another important town in China called Shanghai, which is the headquarters of New Development Bank, also called BRICS Bank. And China's currency is yuan, or you can say renminbi. And China's president is Xi Jinping, who recently met Rex Tillerson, who is the Secretary of State of Donald Trump's government. And Prime Minister of China is Li Keqiang. Next. Which airport was awarded World's Best Airport for the fifth consecutive year by 2017 Skytrax World Airport Survey? Fifth time in a row, the best airport in the world is Changi Airport, which is in Singapore. And Singapore, that's all you need to know. Capital is Singapore City. In an industry first, which bank launched digital loan against securities, LAS, allowing the customers to avail loans in less than 3 minutes? This is the first time in this industry. So this is the HDFC Bank. And HDFC Bank is headquartered at Mumbai. And its CEO is Aditya Puri, who is also one of the most powerful persons in the banking and financial ecosystem. As per a research published in journal PLOS Biology, the scientists of the Swedish Museum of Natural History have found fossils of 1.6 billion year old probable red algae. Okay, red algae. Now, the oldest ever plant fossils were found in which district in India? Which district in India had these 1.6 billion year old red algae fossils? It is in Chitrakoot in Uttar Pradesh. Chitrakoot in Uttar Pradesh. Chitrakoot is a town of historical importance. It finds its mention in the great Ramayana also. Namibia Institute of Public Administration and Management has signed an MOU with which Indian institute? Namibia Institute of PABED. It has signed with Lal Bahadur Shastri National Academy of Administration, which is the dream destination for a lot of UPSC aspirants. Who has been appointed as the vice president of the local organizing committee of the FIFA Under 17 World Cup, which is to be held in India? This is a very, very important question. It is Babul Supriyo from West Bengal, singer, very famous singer also. And who is the president of All India Football Federation? It is Praful Patel. Praful Patel. Meghalaya government, it tabled a 1236 crore deficit budget for the financial year 2017. Who holds the finance portfolio in the state? So who is the finance minister of Meghalaya? Finance minister of Meghalaya is Mukul Sangma. Chief Minister Mukul Sangma, he has the finance portfolio. Meghalaya, the capital is Shillong. And Meghalaya also has a very famous place, Cherrapunji, which has another, near which we have the Mosenram, which is the wettest area in the world. Sanjoli police station has become the first police post in the country to be linked with crime and criminal tracking network and system, CCTNS. It is located in which state? Sanjoli. Sanjoli police station is located in Himachal Pradesh. And Himachal Pradesh has a Congress government. Chief Minister is Veerbhadra Singh. In which city was the 5th International Convention on Changing Dynamics of Commodities Market recently organized? It was an international convention which took place in New Delhi this time. New Delhi. And our Union Minister for Agriculture and Farmers is Radhamohan Singh. India recently finalized the text of Social Security Agreement with which country? Text of Social Security Agreement. SSA in short. It is with Brazil. And till date, India has signed Social Security Agreement with 18 countries. And what exactly is this Social Security Agreement? A detached worker of the two countries are exempted from making Social Security contribution in either country, as long as they were making such contribution in their respective countries. That is the Social Security Agreement. And Brazil capital is Brasilia. Currency is Brazilian Real, R-E-A-L. And president is Michel Temer. Which bank has been awarded first prize in the implementation of official language policy in the Western region for the year 2015-2016? It is the Central Bank of India. Central Bank of India, it is headquartered again in Mumbai. Chairman and Managing Director is Rajiv Rishi. Rajiv Rishi. And the official language conference of Central and Western regions was held in Udaipur recently. Which international financial institution has approved a $175 million loan for the National Hydrology Project to improve India's ability to forecast floods? Floods which cause great havoc in India. Now we will be able to predict floods better with the National Hydrology Project. It will be funded by the World Bank. And World Bank, the president is Jim Yong Kim. Headquarter is in Washington, D.C., which also has headquarters of International Monetary Fund. European aviation major Airbus. Airbus is a company of France. Very, very important company. And the major rival of Boeing. France also has another important company called Rafael. But Rafael manufactures not commercial planes. It mainly manufactures fighter planes. We bought Rafael from, actually the name of the company is different, it is called Dassault Aviation, and the fighter planes are called Rafael actually. So European aviation company Airbus is going to set up Asia's first greenfield training facility. Asia's first greenfield training facility at which place? It will be set up in New Delhi. Very important. And Airbus headquarters is in Toulouse in France. That's all you need to know. Yeah, you should know our civil aviation minister also. He's associated with this question. It is Gajapati Raju. So P. Ashok Gajapati Raju is our civil aviation minister. What is the name of Indian-American teenager who won the Regeneron Science Talent Search competition with almost 500,000 prize for her research on treating brain injury and disease. Indian-American teenager. And that is why this question is important. Her name is Indrani Das. Indrani Das. This is not a small award. This is called Junior Nobel Prize in some circuits. It is one of the oldest US science competition for students. Which railway research center has entered into an agreement with the Indian Railways to support future research and technology development? It is, this railway research center is at Australia. Its name is Monash University Institute of Railway Technology. It has partnered with Indian Railways. So that's you need to know. And this research and development institute in India is known as Shrestha. That also you need to know. Shresht, what is the full form? Special Railway Establishment. Special Railway Establishment for Strategic Technology and Holistic Advancement. In short, Shresht. As per the Women in Politics 2017 map, which was launched by Inter-Parliamentary Union, IPU, and UN Women, what was India's rank in world rankings of the country of women parliamentarians out of 193 countries? Very, very important. Does India have a lot of women parliamentarians? How many women MPs do we have? So our number is very, very small. And out of 193 countries, we are ranked at 148. And India was ranked in 88 in the number of women minister rankings. Overall women parliamentarians, we were ranked 148. When it comes to women ministers, we were ranked 88. And Rwanda was ranked number one in this list. And in India, women make up 11.8% in Lok Sabha. And 64 were elected in Lok Sabha out of 542. And in Rajya Sabha, we have 11% only. Out of 245 members of Rajya Sabha right now, we have 27 women who are there. So number is very, very small. A parliamentary panel has suggested merger of BSNL and MTNL. Right? MTNL is what? Mahanagar Telephone Nigam Limited and BSNL is Bharat Sanchar Nigam Limited. So there is a merger which is being proposed. This decision has been taken by which committee? There is a committee for this which is called the Bhagat Singh Koshyari Committee. And please note that BSNL CEO is Mr. Anupam Srivastav, AS. And MTNL CEO is Praveen Purwar, Praveen Kumar Purwar. From which space center did SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket made its third successful flight carrying an EchoStar 23 communication satellite? Which space center is this? It is the Kennedy Space Center in Florida. Very, very important. SpaceX is a project by Elon Musk. Space tourism. Similarly, there is another company called Virgin Atlantic that is into space tourism. So we had also made a video, SpaceX versus ISRO. SpaceX is a little ahead of ISRO right now because it has reusable fuel technology, but ISRO is fast catching up. Cabinet recently gave its approval for revised MOU and MOO for developing Border Heart. India signed the pact with which neighboring country to build Border Heart. This will be built with Bangladesh. MOO is mode of operation. And there are four border hearts that are operational, two each in Meghalaya and in Tripura. Total there are four. And Bangladesh Prime Minister is Sheikh Hasina. As per the budget presented by Tamil Nadu Finance Minister D. Jayakumar, the fiscal deficit of the state stood at 4.58% for the year 2016-17, that is financial year 2017, which is ending in just 9 days. What is the fiscal deficit limit prescribed by the FRBM Act, Fiscal Responsibility and Budget Management Act? And it is 3%, and Tamil Nadu was well above this limit. So this shows what? This shows that the socialist model that the government followed with those canteens and which though it has kind of put lot of load on the exchequer. SEBI, Securities and Exchange Board of India, which is the capital market regulator, it has recently reviewed the celebrity endorsement norms for which of the following financial products? Celebrity endorsement norms. These are meant to be reviewed time and again because otherwise there may be false promises on the part of the various companies. So this has been done for mutual funds. So this will affect all the asset management companies. And SEBI is headquartered in Mumbai and the present chairman is Ajay Tyagi. Next question. Which river in New Zealand, considered to be an ancestor by the Maori people, has become the first in the world to get the same legal rights as a human being? In New Zealand, this river has the same legal rights now as a human being in New Zealand. And this river is the very, very famous Wan Ganui River, and it is the third largest river of New Zealand. This bill was passed in New Zealand recently, and New Zealand Prime Minister name is Bill English, and New Zealand's capital is Wellington. Which of the following cricket legends recently launched his autobiography called My Story? So which cricketer has recently written his autobiography called My Story? It is the great cricketer of Australia, Michael Clerk. Michael John Clerk. He's a former captain of Australia and international cricketer. He had retired in 2015 from all forms of cricket. Where is the first of its kind international summit called Global Millennium Summit 2017 being held? And the theme is Future of the Millennium. Future of the Millennium. And the first time an Indian institute has organized an international summit. It is organized by Shriram College of Commerce, SRCC, New Delhi. And it is in Dubai, in United Arab Emirates. And our Minister of State for Youth Affairs and Sports is Vijay Goyal. And he was the chief guest at this summit. India recently signed a memorandum of understanding with Indonesia and Kyrgyzstan Republic for cooperation in which field? With two countries. One is the Kyrgyz Republic and the second is the Indonesia. Indonesia capital is Jakarta and Kyrgyzstan capital is Bishkek. We signed it for youth affairs. Youth affair. So that's all you need to know. Which badminton player has recently been named on the governing body of SAI, which is the Sports Authority of India? And it is headquartered in New Delhi. This badminton player is Juala Gatta. And it is the apex body, governing body, it is the apex body of sports affairs. So that's all you need to know. What is the name of the robot that is developed by Maharashtra Institute of Technology? This is not Massachusetts, this is MIT. This is Maharashtra Institute of Technology, Pune, in collaboration with IBM, designed to assist senior citizens in everyday life, in everyday, day-to-day, mundane tasks. This robot is called Chintu. Chintu. And IBM, it is headquartered in New York. Government has decided to conduct a field trial of which denomination of plastic banknotes in five locations of the country. It is rupees 10. And approval for procurement of plastic notes has been conveyed to the Reserve Bank of India. Trial will be at Kochi, Mysore, Jaipur, Shimla and Bhubaneswar. And our Minister of State for Finance is Arjun Ram Meghwal. Ashwin Sundar passed away recently. He was a famous what? So very, very unfortunate incident. Ashwin Sundar was driving his BMW car along with his wife Nivedita. And the car hit a tree. It was speeding and caught fire. And both of them were charred to death. So, he was a very famous professional car racer. Union Cabinet has approved the increment of dearness allowance to central government employees and dearness relief to pensioners. Starting from 1st January 2017, from the existing 2% to what amount? Dearness allowance is given to compensate for the increase in inflation and 2%, now it has been increased from 2% to 4%. 4%. It will put an extra load of almost 11,000 crore rupees on the exchequer annually. Where was the conference of the G20 finance ministers and central bank governors recently held? It took place at a place called Baden, which is in Germany. And in November 2008, the G20 leaders had met for the first time in Washington, D.C. So this was, India is a member of G20. So G20 finance ministers met in Germany. Where was the 9-day long National Theatre Festival, which showcased 17 drama from various regional languages recently held? It was organized in Thiruvananthapuram, the capital of Kerala. And Thiruvananthapuram, Kerala has a CPIM government, Marxist Communist Party of India. Pinarayi Vijayan is the chief minister. Central government has announced to infuse 418 crore rupees in which public sector bank as a part of turnaround linked capital infusion plan, which this bank was in loss and 418 crore will be infused in it. It is the United Bank of India. United Bank of India, it is headquartered in Kolkata and CEO is Mr. P. Srinivas. which aircraft manufacturer has signed a 3.4 billion contract with US Army for 268 AH-64E Apache helicopters? Which aircraft manufacturer is this? It is US's own Boeing, and it is headquartered in Chicago in America. Which Congress politician has been nominated as the new chairman of the Public Accounts Committee? PAC chairman will be Mallikarjun Khadge. He will succeed K.V. Thomas. And PAC, it is a committee of 22 member of parliaments, which is constituted for auditing of the revenue and the expenditures of the government of India. Which of the following space agencies launched a spy satellite, Radar 5, to track North Korean and Chinese military movements on the H-2A rocket? So what is the name for this? Which of the following space agency? So this space agency is of Japan. It is called Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency, also called JAXA. And Russia's space agency is called Roscosmos, which was in news. America's is NASA, and ISRO is of India's. These are some of the agencies that you need to know. Japan's Prime Minister is Shinzo Abe, very important. And Japan's currency is yen, and capital is, of course, Tokyo. Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs, CCEA, has given its approval for marketing and pricing freedom to the contractors of which of these? This will be done for coal bed methane. And coal bed methane, it will be sold in the domestic markets, and it will be sold at arm's length price, which means arm's length means a transaction in which the buyers and sellers of a product act independently and they have no relationship with each other. Recently launched ESAF, Small Finance Bank, is which state's first private sector bank in microfinancing, ESAF, and this is Kerala's. Managing Director and CEO of this bank is K. Paul Thomas, and chairman of this bank is R. Prabha. For dedicating their lives to social work, 11 Indians among the 25 Asian women won the Women Icons Award in which country? 11 Indians. There were 25 Asian women. They were honored for their exceptional social work. These awards were held in Singapore, in the Nanyang Technological University, NTU. Which American state has declared March 16 as the Indian American Appreciation Day to honor Indian engineer Srinivas Kuchi Botla, who was killed in an apparent hate crime? Srinivas Kuchi Botla was killed in a hate crime in America, and Kansas state has declared Indian American Appreciation Day, and this was a very, very unfortunate incident that took place. In a first, scientists at the Rensselaer Polytechnic Institute, RPI in short, have found a blood test which was able to diagnose which of the following mental disorders. Blood test to diagnose mental disorders. This is for autism. Autism is a disability that affects a lot of people, in which it's a developmental disability of the neurological apparatus. Cash-E, it is a financial technology product promoted by Ares Financial Technology. It has entered into a strategic partnership with which online marketplace for financial products? It has entered into a partnership with Rubik. And Rubik will enlist Cash-E on their online platform. And the founder and chairman of Cash-E is Raman Kumar. And for Rubik is Manavjit Singh. He is the founder and CEO of Rubik. Next question. Which private sector bank has entered into a partnership with Avenues India to help the merchants get access to point of sale and payment gateway products? And this is very important bank. I have told you about it. Bandhan Bank, microfinancing. And Bandhan Bank, its CEO is Chandrasekhar Ghosh. He is the CEO. He is the founder also, Chandrasekhar Ghosh. And it is headquartered at Kolkata. Cabinet recently approved the IIIT PPP Bill 2017. How many IIITs set up under the public-private partnership mode would now be able to grant degrees? How many? PPP is private-public partnership, and these have been declared as Institute of National Importance. So total 15. 15 IIITs will be able to award degrees now. Which state recently organized the first ever Sahitya Sangam? Sahitya means literature. Sangam means like a collaboration, like where various things meet. and felicitated 30 odd veteran scholars. Sahitya Sangam was organized in Panchkula in Haryana. And Haryana's chief minister is Manohar Lal Khattar of Bharatiya Janata Party. And governor of Haryana is Kaptan Singh Solanki. Indian Council of Agricultural Research, ICAR, and the International Crops Research Institute for the Semi-Arid Tropics, ICRISAT, have joined hands to work together on what ICAR and ICRISAT will together work on: crop improvement. And please note that ICAR was founded in 1929. So it's a very old organization. And of course, the president is Radha Mohan Singh. How many months extension has been given by the Union Environment Ministry as a one-time opportunity to industrial projects functioning without environmental clearance to apply for a backdated green certificate? How many months extension has been given by our Ministry of Environment as a one-time opportunity only to the industrial projects functioning without environment clearance? They can now apply for a backdated green certificate, else they will have to shut down. So total 6 months extension has been given. And who is our Minister of State for Environment? It is Anil Madhav Dave. Derek Walcott passed away recently. He was a Nobel Prize winner in which field? Derek Walcott. So he was for literature, and he was very famous for his poems. Cabinet gave its approval for signing an MOU with which country for greater cooperation with regard to marine aids to navigation? So which country will we have maritime cooperation? We have signed a collaboration. It is with Bangladesh. What is the name of India's first made in India, that is indigenous built rake, that was flagged off at Dadar station in Mumbai recently? First rake is called Medha, and Medha has been manufactured by the Integral Coach Factory, which is in Chennai. The answer is Medh. Next question is very important. Anang Tadar, he is a class 11 student, and he has developed goggles for blind, G4B, based on echolocation, and he is from which state? And these goggles can really improve the quality of life of the visually impaired. He is from Arunachal Pradesh. Arunachal Pradesh has a BJP government, and chief minister is Pema Khandu. Indian American Sandeep Matharani has been listed fourth on the list of top 25 overpaid CEOs in America as per a report by the non-profit As You Sow organization. He is the CEO of which company? Sandeep Matharani. He is the overpaid CEO of General Growth Properties. And this list was topped by Leslie Moonves, who is CEO of CBS. Pakistan is planning to declare which of the following regions as its fifth province? And this has really offended a lot of Indians. It is Gilgit-Baltistan. It's a disputed territory. And it's a geographical boundary with POK, and India considers it as a part of the undivided Jammu and Kashmir. For which fighter jets fleet of the Indian Air Force did India and Russia sign key agreements for long-term maintenance support? This is for the Sukhoi Su-30 MKI, which we have got from Russia. Sukhoi is Russian apparatus. Which city hosted the International Diamond Conference? It was also participated in by video conferencing by Narendra Modi, and the theme was Mines to Market 2017. It was in New Delhi, the capital. NTPC, National Thermal Power Corporation, again a Maharatan company, it announced commissioning of its second unit of 660 megawatt thermal power station. At which thermal power station located in Maharashtra? This is at the Mauda Super Thermal Power Station, and total capacity has become more than 2000 megawatt now. So that you have to remember, total capacity of Mauda Super Thermal Power Station has exceeded 2000 megawatt now. And NTPC Group total thermal power capacity has become 48,873 megawatt now. That is how much important NTPC is to India. And who is the CEO of NTPC? It is Mr. Gurdeep Singh, and it is headquartered at New Delhi. Who has been appointed as the chairman of National Commission for Safai Karamchari? Safai means cleanliness, Karamchari means volunteers. Safai Karamcharis. It is Mr. Manhar Walji Bhai Zala. Manzar Walji Bhai Zala. who launched the first ever mobile app in the world, which is dedicated to breast health, named ABC of Breast Health, at an event organized by Usha Lakshmi Breast Cancer Foundation in Mumbai. It was launched by Mr. Amitabh Bachchan, the famous actor, and it gives information about breast cancer in 12 Indian languages. Where was the 15th All India Meet of States Legal Services Authorities recently held in India? It was held in New Delhi. As per a recent report by Ministry of Finance, 29 lakh debit cards, they were subjected to malware attack in India last year by being used at ATMs that were connected to the switch provided by which company? This switch was provided by which company? It was provided by Hitachi Payment Services. 29 lakh debit cards were subjected to malware attack. And out of these 29 lakh, only 3,291 cards were, they had faced unauthorized access. So mostly were safe. Where was the 3-day International Buddhist Council organized by the Ministry of Culture and Nava Naranda Mahavihar recently took place? Buddhist Council, this took place in Bihar, in Rajgir. And it was inaugurated by Dalai Lama, with the Minister of Culture and Tourism, Mahesh Sharma. Minister of Culture and Tourism is Mahesh Sharma. The theme was Buddhism in the 21st Century, Perspectives and Responses to Global Challenges and Crisis. As per a report presented by Union Minister for Drinking Water and Sanitation, Mahinder Singh Tomar, which state has highest number of arsenic-affected people in India? This is very, very important. Most arsenic-affected people in India, more than 1 crore people are affected, is in West Bengal. Second is Bihar and third is Assam. Please note that permissible limit of arsenic in water is 0.6 milligram per liter. Legendary musician Chuck Berry passed away recently. He was associated with which genre of music? He was associated with rock and roll. Rock and roll. Who won the men's single title at the BNP Paribas Open tennis tournament at the India Wells Tennis Garden? It is also called India Wells Tennis Tournament. He beat his compatriot Stan Wawrinka in the final. He is Roger Federer. This is a very, very important question. Which famous cricketer has been appointed as the ambassador of the 5th Blind Cricket World Cup, which will be held in UAE and Pakistan jointly? He is Shahid Afridi, the great batsman Shahid Afridi, who had announced his retirement recently. Which two telecom companies are merging together to build India's largest telecom network? This is to take on Jio. Two companies that are merging are Vodafone and Idea. Vodafone and Idea have merged together. So answer is 1 and 2. So Vodafone will hold 45% in the combined company that will be formed after the merger. And Idea promoters will hold 26% in the combined entity. Kumar Mangalam Birla, he will be the chairman of the joint entity. Indian-American Anshu Mali Srivastav won National Science Foundation's Career Award for research in which field recently? Anshu Mali Srivastav won the award for computer science recently. Computer science, works at the Rice University. International Day of Happiness was observed on March the 20th. Which country tops the happiness index as per the 2017 World Happiness Report, which ranks 155 countries? Second is Denmark, third is Iceland, but the first is Norway. Norway capital is Oslo, and Norway also has a very important player, Magnus Carlsen. Chess. Which state has approved 33% reservation for women in all state government jobs and 50% in Panchayati Raj and urban local bodies? Which state is this? This state is Punjab, which has a new government, Congress government. Captain Amrinder Singh is the chief minister. The noted Gujarati poet Chinu Modi recently passed away. What was his pen name? So pen name is the name that the authors and poets, they keep for writing imaginary name that becomes very famous because it is written in their works. And his name was Irshad. Pen name was Irshad. Who has been appointed by the government as a member on the Western Area Local Board of the Reserve Bank of India? Which person? He is the managing director of Sun Pharma. And he has been appointed for a period of 4 years. His name is Dilip Sanghvi, one of India's richest persons. Mera iMobile. It is an app that allows the users in rural area to access the banking services. It has been launched by which bank? And it also provides information about various agriculture services. Mera iMobile has been launched by ICICI Bank. It is available in 11 languages. And ICICI Bank headquarters is also in Mumbai. And its chairman, its CEO is Chanda Kochar. ONGC, Oil and Natural Gas Corporation is going to acquire which company's entire 80% stake in KG Basin natural gas block for a whopping $1.2 billion. That is almost, that is more than 8,000 crore rupees. This is the Gujarat State Petroleum Corporation. It will acquire Gujarat State Petroleum Corporation's 80% stake in KG Basin natural gas block. And about ONGC, you should know that ONGC's CEO is Dinesh Sarraf. How many Indians have featured in the World Economic Forum's 100 Young Global Leaders list of 2017? There are only 5 Indians in the World Economic Forum's 100 Young Global Leaders. Who are they? One is Vijay Shekhar Sharma, who is the founder of Paytm. Then you have Shruti Shibulal, who is from the Tamara Hospitality. Ambarish Mitra, founder and CEO of Blipper. It is a mobile phone app. Then you have Hindal Sen Gupta, who is the editor at large of Fortune India. And you have Ritwik Bhattacharya Agarwal, founder and CEO of Swaniti Initiative. Committee of Administrators, COA, constituted by the Supreme Court, finalized a new constitution for which sports governing body? Committee of Administrators. This is for BCCI, Board of Control for Cricket in India. And 4 people are in the Committee of Administrators, COA. One is our ex-CAG Vinod Rai. Then Ramchandra Guha, the noted historian, writer, Vikram Limaye, and Diana Adulji. Please note my next question. Vikram Limaye, he is associated with which bank? Field trials were recently completed for India's longest road tunnel connecting Chennai and Nashiri town. It is located in which state? India's longest tunnel. So India's longest tunnel is located in Jammu and Kashmir. It will connect Chennai and Nashiri towns. So I think I mispronounced it at Chennai. It is not Chennai, it is Chennai. Chennai and Nashiri towns in Jammu and Kashmir. It is built at a cost of 3,720 crore rupees in 6 years. It will be inaugurated by Prime Minister Narendra Modi in the end of March. And it is in Udhampur district. Which country has topped the 2017 Bloomberg Global Health Index that rated 167 countries? Which country topped it? Healthiest country in the world, it is Italy. And second was Iceland, and third was Switzerland. And Italy capital is Rome. Prime Minister is Paolo Gentiloni. And currency is Euro. Who has been appointed as the new CEO of digital wallet company FreeCharge, which is owned by Snapdeal? FreeCharge, who is the CEO? It is Mr. Jason Kothari. He is the new CEO of FreeCharge. And who is the CEO of Snapdeal? It is Kunal Behel. A much faster Wi-Fi system has been developed by scientists from the Eindhoven University of Technology, which is in Netherlands. Eindhoven Institute of University of Technology. It is based on which technology? It is Verify Wi-Fi. It is based on the infrared technology. Infrared. It is 100 times faster than the wireless fidelity network or the Wi-Fi network. So it is based on infrared. Dev Raj Sikka passed away recently. He was a famous what? So he was a famous meteorologist or the person who studies weather phenomena. And he was the first to propose a link between El Nino and Indian monsoon. Very, very important. El Nino significantly reduces the intensity of the monsoons and therefore causes drought, etc. in India. Which of the following rivers of India has become the first in India to receive the rights of a living entity? Which river in India has become the first to receive right of a living entity? It is the Holy Ganges, Ganga River. Ganga along with river Yamuna by Uttarakhand High Court. So if someone pollutes river Ganga, the law will see it equal to harming of a human being. So Ganga and Yamuna, both. World Sparrow Day is observed on March 20th every year. It is an initiative by which environmental organization in India? World Sparrow Day by Nature Forever Society. And now you will see that in urban areas, especially, the sparrows are on the verge of extinction because the new houses that are built, they don't have cavities in which sparrows can build the nests. And also there is a deep disconnect between the youth of today and the nature. So nobody keeps water, food for sparrows on their rooftops. So please keep water if you want to help sparrows from getting extinct. Government of India has notified the swapping of Managing Director and Chief Executive Officers of which two banks? So MD and CEO of which two banks have been swapped? They are IDBI and Indian Bank. IDBI and Indian Bank CEOs. 1 and 4 is the answer. Mr. Kishore Piraji Kharat is MD and CEO of Indian Bank, which is headquartered at Chennai Indian Bank. And IDBI, it is headquartered in Mumbai. And Mr. Mahesh Kumar Jain is MD and CEO of IDBI. How many legislations did Union Cabinet approve to implement goods and services tax? Goods and services tax. How many legislations? It is 4. One is the Central GST Bill 2017. One is Integrated GST Bill. And then Union Territory of GST Bill and GST Compensation for the States Bill. So total 4 legislations. Which township in Surat district of Gujarat has become India's first private sector township to go cashless? First private sector township to go cashless is in Surat in Gujarat. It is the Nand Niketan SR. Nand Niketan, which is made by SR Group. What is the name of former Rajya Sabha MP, popularly called Chanakya of Odisha politics, who recently passed away? Chanakya of Odisha politics. He was Pyari Mohan Mohapatra. He was president of Odisha Jan Morch party. Finance Ministry has prepared a turnaround linked rupees 8,586 crore capital infusion plan for how many public sector banks? This much amount will be infused in how many banks to give them a new lease of life? And maximum amount of out of this will be in IDBI Bank, that is 1900 crore rupees. Total 10 PSBs, public sector banks, will receive this cash infusion. Which of the following small scale units will be provided financial assistance by the government in the form of capital subsidy for installation of solar photovoltaic plants? Solar photovoltaic plants. It is the power loom units. They will be provided financial assistance by the government. Competition Commission of India has approved the Reliance Communications proposed merger with which telecom service provider? Reliance Communications will merge with Aircel. Aircel. And Reliance Communications CEO is Gurdeep Singh. And Aircel CEO is Kaizad Hirji. And both of these companies will have 50% each in the merged entity. Scientists at European Organization for Nuclear Research, which is called CERN, have discovered a new system of 5 particles all in a single analysis using which particle accelerator? This is a question from Science and Technology. And CERN headquartered at Geneva in Switzerland. And this is the Large Hadron Collider. In his marathon innings, which cricket player became the first Indian batsman to face 500 balls in an innings? He was criticized also for playing slow. His name is Cheteshwar Pujara. Cheteshwar Pujara. Directorate General of Civil Aviation, DGCA, has asked the airlines to disallow oversized hand baggage on flights operating at performance limited airports. Who is the present Director General of DGCA? It is Mr. B.S. Buller. Airports having runway length limitation and other aspects will not allow oversized hand baggages now. Tata Motors has signed an agreement with which German automaker to explore cooperation in India? It has done it with Volkswagen, also pronounced as Foxwagen. And they can also ask who is the managing director and CEO of Tata. This is a very important question. His name is Guenter Butschek. Guenter Butschek. KT Irfan, he won the bronze at the Asian Championship in Japan. He plays which sport? He plays which sport? Race walking is his sport. Asian Race Walking Championship. And he's a national record holder in men's 20 kilometer walk. Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs, CCEA, gave its principal approval for selling how much percentage of Indian Oil Corporation's stake in Lubrizol India Private Limited to Lubrizol Corporation? How much stake was this? It was 24% stake. India and Pakistan held a two-day Indus Water Commission meeting at which place? Indus Water Treaty, central to the water supply needs of Pakistan, and Indus Water meeting took place at Islamabad. Islamabad. In which state the economic blockade called by a political party finally came to an end after 139 days? So it was called by the United Naga Council in Manipur. Very, very important. World Bank Group President Jim Yong Kim today announced a record $57 billion in financing over the next 3 years for which countries? World Bank Group President Jim Yong Kim announced a record $57 billion for the sub-Saharan countries. Sub-Saharan countries. Which state has announced to set up a cashew development board to promote development of good quality cashew orchards over the next 5 years? Cashew development board will be by Karnataka, which sees a very high quality of cashews. And Karnataka, recent news is that Karnataka ex-chief minister S.M. Krishna has joined Bharatiya Janata Party today. And Karnataka's present chief minister is Siddaramaiah of Congress. E-commerce company Snapdeal has partnered with which country's external trade organization to showcase popular small and medium enterprise products on their marketplace? So which country's small and medium enterprise products will now be on Snapdeal? They have partnered with Japan. Who has been appointed as the Director of National Intelligence, approved by the US Congress? Director of National Intelligence, Dan Coats. Very, very important. Dan Coats. Four new scientific advisors have been roped in for which sport by its governing body? I mean to say, in India, to make this sport better, four scientific advisors have been inculcated in this body, and this is by the Hockey India. And who is the president of Hockey India's Hockey's governing body? It is Mariamma Koshi. Mariamma Koshi is president of Hockey India. Railways has announced to establish a museum to commemorate the visit of Swami Vivekanand at which station in Tamil Nadu? Swami Vivekanand's visit at Kumbakonam in Tamil Nadu. Kumbakonam. Can you name any other very, very important personality who was born at Kumbakonam? Madhukar Gupta Committee, which recently submitted its report, was constituted for what? It was constituted for our border security, to strengthen the border protection and address the vulnerability at the India-Pakistan border. And who is our Union Minister of State for Home Affairs? Kiran Rijiju. Which state government has announced a Rs. 10 crore fund, Idea to POC, proof of concept, for women entrepreneurs? Idea to proof of concept. This has been announced by the government of Karnataka. Karnataka. Where was the 3-day long event of 6th edition of the International Engineering Sourcing Show IESS recently held? It was held in Chennai recently, and this was organized under the aegis of Union Ministry of Commerce and Industry, for which we have the Cabinet Minister Nirmala Sitharaman. In the previous question, you should know one more thing also. In Karnataka, they are also making Namma canteens, and 100 crore rupees has been allotted for the same. They are government-subsidized canteens. Which Indian state has received a $210 million loan for strengthening the Gram Panchayat? $210 million loan for strengthening Gram Panchayat. This will be in West Bengal. West Bengal. What is the name of Director General of ICMR who has joined a United Nations group on antimicrobial resistance? Indian Council for Medical Research. Who is the Director General? His name is Soumya Swaminathan. He has joined a United Nations group on antimicrobial resistance. ISRO is headquartered at Bengaluru. It has commissioned the world's third largest hypersonic wind tunnel and shock tunnel at which facility? It is done at the Vikram Sarabhai Space Center in Thiruvananthapuram. Vikram Sarabhai Space Center, which is in Thiruvananthapuram. And ISRO chairman is Kiran Kumar. What was the theme of United Nations International Day of Forest, which was observed on March 21st? International Day of Forest. Forest and energy, this time was the theme. This day has been celebrated since 2013. Who has received the second highest peacetime gallantry award, Kirti Chakra, for leading the team which carried out surgical strike against terrorist hideout in POK? So who has been awarded Kirti Chakra? It is Major Rohit Suri. He belongs to the parachute regiment, and Corporal Gursevak Singh of Indian Air Force was posthumously conferred the Shaurya Chakra. So there were total 13 Shaurya Chakra which were awarded. Out of those, six were awarded posthumously. Cabinet has approved merger of which of the following banks with State Bank of India? So it is the Bharatiya Mahila Bank. And before that, five banks have already merged with SBI. Which country is going to launch its first sign language dictionary in both print and video? First sign language dictionary. It will be developed by the Indian Sign Language Research and Training Center, ISLRTC. So it will be done by India. And who is our Minister for Social Justice and Empowerment? Thavar Chand Gehlot. Mukesh Ambani, who topped the Indian billionaires list, at which place he ranks in the Forbes list of the world billionaires? He is at place 33. And who is at number 1? Bill Gates. So Bill Gates is fourth year in a row, he is number 1, and Donald Trump is ranked at 544. Reserve Bank of India recently proposed to fix the upper limit for prepaid payment instrument if the customers provide full KYC to what amount? So if KYC is done, then for prepaid instrument, the limit is 1 lakh rupees. 1 lakh. And if KYC is not done, then it is 20,000. What was the theme of the 5th Foundation Day of BIRAC? Which is, and you should know the full form of BIRAC also. So that you have to write in comments. Do you know the full form of BIRAC? And our Minister for Science and Technology and Earth Science is Dr. Harshvardhan. And the theme was impacting the biotech ecosystem. Impacting the biotech ecosystem. How many projects worth 1900 crore rupees have been approved for Namami Gange program across 4 states? Total number of projects is 20. In Uttarakhand, Bihar, Jharkhand and Delhi, and approved by the Executive Committee of National Mission for Clean Ganga, Namami Gange. And who is our Minister for Ganga Cleaning and Water Resources and River Development? It is Uma Bharti. India has signed an MOU worth $20 million for constructing housing projects in which country? India will build houses in which country? It is Mauritius. Mauritius capital is Port Louis. And who is our Minister for Urban Development? Venkaiah Naidu. Which city has been ranked the cheapest in India by Economist Intelligence Unit's EIU Worldwide Cost of Living 2017 report? Which is India's cheapest city? It is Bengaluru. I am sure people who are living in Bengaluru will think differently. Next. And another thing, that Bangalore, when it comes to world, it is third cheapest. If they ask which is the cheapest city in the world, it is Almaty in Kazakhstan. And most Singapore is Singapore for the fourth time in a row. Singapore. Next, which Indian snooker player won the silver medal at the Women's World Snooker Championship in Singapore? Which Indian snooker player won the silver medal? So when we talk about snooker, there is always one player that comes to mind, Pankaj Advani, but now it is Vidya Pillai this time. And this was the Women's World Snooker Championship, so it is Vidya Pillai. And gold medal was won by Hong Kong's Nag On E. And Vidya Pillai is 8 times Women National Snooker Champion. World Poetry Day was celebrated on March 21st, that is yesterday. It was declared by UNESCO in which year? So when was the first World Poetry Day celebrated? It was in 1999. Who has been appointed a new whole-time member of SEBI for a period of 3 years? SEBI, Securities Exchange Board of India, its whole-time member new is Madhapuri Book. Madhavipuri Book. Which team won the 2017 Vijay Hazare Trophy, beating Bengal in the final? Vijay Hazare Trophy, and this team is Tamil Nadu. It won the 2017 Vijay Hazare Trophy, named after the legendary player Vijay Hazare. Maggie McDonald, who won the Global Teachers Prize 2017, teaches a small Inuit village in which country? The village that she teaches in is called Selui, and she has set up many programs at the local level for skill development, and she won the Global Teacher Award. She is in Canada. And Canada's head of state is Justin Trudeau, who is the head of state in Canada. And Canada's capital is Ottawa. Which city hosted the second India-UAE conference on globalization, which was organized by AIMA? Which city is that? It was hosted by Dubai. And UAE capital is Abu Dhabi, and currency is dirham. Which state has approved the disbursal of arrears to the government employees as per the salary hike in the 7th pay commission? So which state is implementing the 7th pay commission? It is Assam. And the salary will be paid as per the 7th pay commission. Who is the chairman of 7th pay commission? A.K. Mathur. And who is the finance minister of Assam? Hemant Biswas Sarma. When was International Day for Elimination of Racial Discrimination observed? And the theme was racial profiling and incitement to hatred, including in the context of migration. So when was this International Day for Elimination of Racial Discrimination? It was established after the Sharpeville massacre in 1960, which was a racial crime, and March 21 is the answer. Which city is hosting the 18th edition of the 3-day-long convention Fikki Frames 2017? It is being held in Mumbai by Fikki. Fikki president is Pankaj Patel. They can ask in exam. Pankaj Patel is the Fikki president. UN Secretary General recently proposed to shut down UN peacekeeping mission in Haiti and replace it with a smaller mission who is the Secretary General of United Nations presently? It is Mr. Antonio Guterres. This was an easy question. Government has proposed a labor code which will provide social security cover to the entire workforce in the country. Who is our Minister for Labor and Employment? It is Mr. Bandaru Dattatreya. He is the Union Minister for the same. And recently he has proposed a labor code in India. We will do a separate video on labor code. Which of the following engineering institute has featured in the top 30 of Asia University ranking 2017 by the Times Higher Education? Engineering institute in top 30 of the Asia University ranking, it is our IISc Bengaluru, Indian Institute of Science, Bengaluru. And the first was NUS, National University of Singapore. Which union ministry unveiled the new national building code, which was prepared by the Bureau of Indian Standards? New national building code is proposed by the Ministry of Consumer Affairs. Ministry of Consumer Affairs. And who is our union minister for the same? It is Mr. Ram Vilas Paswan. India and Pakistan recently joined SCO, Shanghai Cooperation Organization, as the full-time member. Where is the secretariat of Shanghai Cooperation Organization? It was founded in 2001. Now full-time members have become 8. China, Russia, Kazakhstan, Uzbekistan, Tajikistan, Kyrgyzstan, and India, Pakistan. Total 8. Its secretariat is in Beijing. Department of Animal Husbandry, Dairying and Fisheries has planned to launch a pilot scheme for promoting ornamental fisheries sector with an outlay of how much amount? It will be implemented by the National Fisheries Development Board and allocation for the same is 60 crore rupees. 400 species of marine ornamental fishes and 375 freshwater ornamental varieties are available in India. National Health Policy. We have done 2 videos on National Health Policy already, which has been prepared on the lines of Obamacare, has recently been approved by the Cabinet. It will replace the health policy previously framed in which year? It will replace the old health policy of 2002. And our health minister is JP Nadda for our Health and Family Welfare Union Minister. Human Fertilization and Embryology Authority, which is called HEFA, it has granted the first ever permission to carry out a new 3-parent baby fertility technique. HEFA is the fertility clinics regulator in which country? HEFA. It is in United Kingdom. Finance Ministry recently announced its decision to make Aadhaar card mandatory for which of these things? Ministry of Finance. Aadhaar card is now mandatory for PAN and IT returns both. So the answer is 1 and 3. Which e-commerce company has launched A to Z GST guide program in its pilot phase to train sellers for GST, which is to be rolled out from July? It is done by Amazon. And Amazon founder is Jeff Bezos. Bombay Stock Exchange has tied up with which algorithmic-based analysis firm to report social media updates related to 40,000 globally listed stocks? So just mug this up. This is Centifi. Centifi is the algorithmic-based analysis firm. It has partnered with Bombay Stock Exchange. And Bombay Stock Exchange CEO is Ashish Kumar Chauhan. And we have the last question for today. Jet Airways has announced a partnership with which cab aggregator for providing its customers the facility to book airport cabs through the Jet Airways app itself? Now you can book this company's cabs from the Jet Airways app. It is done by Uber. And Uber CEO, he had visited India, very, very important name, Travis Kalanick. Just mug this name up. It has been asked in a lot of exams. Travis Kalanick. And Uber is headquartered in San Francisco. And Jet Airways CEO is Amit Agarwal. Amit Agarwal is the CEO of Jet Airways. So this was a marathon session on the best multiple choice questions for this week. And the quality, I was very impressed with the quality of questions this week. And surely you will find a lot of these questions in the exams to come. Thanks for watching and keep supporting StudyIQ.